It's amazing to hear all of the things that all of y'all have spoken about as to what it means to be Indian, whether it's the values, the diversity, dharma, the exposure that we've been given as a country as a whole because of the different cultures that our country has. But the one thing I think that resonates with all of you on this table is the fact that India is one big family. And it's something that's great to see. It's something that I've always believed in. I feel that mostly every Indian in the world would stand by the fact that we're one big family. And it's something that I see whenever I go for an event or a cricket match. And you don't need to make friends. Everyone's a friend. And it just happens. But before we sign off from the Vaishali dialogue, I'd like all of y'all to give any one piece of advice to all the Indians in the world listening to this today. What's that one thing that you want to tell them about being Indian, why it means so much to you, and what they should look forward to in the future?
Before that, I think I just made an error. I want to correct a statistical error. It's 60% of our population are 30 and under, and 50% of India's population is 25 and under. I think I said it the other way around. So for me, the Indian philosophy, which is, I think, the best ever science I have come across about being your best self, has been a very empowering toolkit. I would urge and encourage every Indian to delve into this toolkit that we are so privileged to have inherited, and not only delve into it, but share it out magnanimously and generously.
Being your best self. Utej?
So earlier on, I gave you the example of my mom. I want to answer this to another example. So again, close to home, this is my dad. My dad for me is the biggest all-rounder I know. He's a skilled surgeon. He still to this day plays 50 over cricket matches. He is a talented public speaker. The list goes on. For me, he has always told me the importance of hard work, of tenacity, of making the most of the opportunity that we've been very fortunate to have been given, that, you know, the opportunity that many others out there don't get. And there are countless examples out there, right? I could quote many, many Indians out there who have hailed from humble backgrounds and through sheer grit, through sheer blood, sweat, and tears, have built a life for themselves. They've built a life for their families. They've enabled future generations to thrive, and to thrive emphatically. I mean, becoming the CEO of Google, becoming the CEO of Microsoft, setting up companies like, you know, like Flipkart, like Paytm. So for me, I think this idea of being the best version of yourself, of giving something your absolute best shot, is something that unites a lot of Indians around the world. And that would be my, you know, my one piece of advice for anyone out there.
So hard work, tenacity. Rithi, what would your advice be?
Absolutely agree with you both. And I think following on from that as well, having resilience. I actually come from a legal background, which primarily is white middle class people. And I think it's so important for females, but even more, it's more important for people of diverse backgrounds to come together and to actually make that impact. And it's just about following your heart and following your desires.
Following your heart. Niharika?
Great. I absolutely agree with everyone on the panel. And so now thinking what else I can add. So I think one of the things that I've learned from my parents as well is, you know, a sense of always being honest and transparent. And that is something that definitely is, I would like to share, would take you in good stead going forward. And the other thing I think is a sense of community, which strongly comes from, I think, our culture, which takes people. In any country in the world you go to, you know, you will find fellow Indians always ready to help one another. So I think that's something that, you know, always help someone if you are able to, is something that is you should carry forward.
Being honest and helpful.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Niharika.